Hello everyone, Sunset Up 2, and welcome to another mod overview, this time on Cobble for Days, a mod that has the ability for you to use up to 5 tiers of Cobble generators. There's a bunch of stats you can change in the server config under the saves folder, and obviously each tier is pretty much just swapping out wood or diamond, and water, lava, and glass is consistent. So, let's see how each one operates. We'll just break each of these. And see from scratch how each one does. Just clear our inventory here because I don't mind that. So, I'm not sure if that's just supposed to be left over, which obviously, as you can see, it's going a lot slower. So that's its actual tick speed, and then the other is just left over that it's been doing in the background. So, obviously, reasonably paced, but still fairly slow. We've got Cobble, or the second tier, which I'm assuming this is its leftover it's trying to empty out. So we'll just wait until it actually catches up. I could just break it again. And we'll see. And just break them again just in case. Or I could just, I guess, start from scratch. Because that would be quicker. Okay, so first tier, we'll see, is every few ticks. Cobble is a bit faster. Iron is obviously a bit faster, as you can see. Gold and diamond. Just get rid of the skeleton. And yeah, so obviously with the leftover, this should empty out fairly fast. But for the most part, you can accumulate a lot of cobblestone over time with the higher tiers, as you'd expect. But even so, with the leftover, I'm assuming quite a bit would be there, as I've tried with redstone signals, and obviously, as you can tell, nothing has changed. So, with server configs, you've got it so you can change anything related to any of the 5 tiers. Whether it be just the maximum amount of items held in the internal buffer, which is 64, 128, 256, 512, and 1024. You've got the amount of items to generate per update, which seems to be just one every time here, which obviously you could tweak a lot higher if you wanted, but either way. The internal, obviously, amount of ticks between every generation is obviously a lot quicker every time, rather than a lot slower, for obvious reasons, and whether or not it pushes automatically to neighbouring inventories. So obviously, if I did want it to push to a chest, I could, or a hopper, or something like that, which we'll actually try with a chest and see. See how much we actually get with this. So quite a bit there. Nothing in the chest there. I'm surprised I didn't open it from underneath because I don't think it would allow me to do that. It seems to not lock things out of the way. Can't do that either, so probably more tubes, for example, to take advantage of this. And we'll get extractor. If I can set this up right or not, it seems. Just so that it's not hopper and we have another method to get some of this cobble out. And wrong way. So I have to remember how to do that. Let's see. Do this and this. There we go. And then some tubes. To actually output it. And a little lower. And that's already filled up, so clearly does fairly fast. Obviously, the extractor I'm using is just going to do everything as best as it can with each stack. And I don't have a clock currently set up to do that, but it seems to be just still removing however many internal amounts there is, unless it's a bug. Nope, so it is updating it. It's just how much was actually in the internals is quite a lot. So, otherwise, thanks so much for watching, and goodbye.